Hooray!
Now I'm sure you all are aware of the tragic story of the one known as Diesel 10. Diesel 10 was first seen back in the year 2000 when he returned to the island of Sodor to try and destroy a lost steam engine. And of course that went up in flames in only a few days, thanks to Thomas. And he was last seen in 2013 when he was stealing some Christmas decorations for some reason. But nobody has seen Diesel 10 since then. Now you may be wondering, what happened to old Diesel 10? Where did he go off to? Well, this is what this video is for. I'm just going to show you what he's been up to in the last 7 years of hiding out. And let's just go and see how everything is.
Thanks, narrator. I assume we won't be hearing from you again until the end of the video, if at all.
Henry, how did you get in here?
Well, the back door was open.
You're right. Knew I was forgetting something.
Sir, master, boss, dictator.
Your Highness, what? Can't you see I'm sulking here?
But sir, why would you want to sulk on a day like this? It's the 7th anniversary of the day you first went into hiding from Sodor.
Did you say 7 years?
Yeah, boss. But what's the deal?
Get the rest of the Diesels in here for a staff meeting.
Are you sure, sir?
Now!
Okay!
All right, men. It's been brought to my attention that it's been 7 years since we've tried to attack Sodor.
But why do we have to waste our time going to that scrap heap anyway?
You'll be a scrap heap if you don't do what Diesel 10 says. Wait, what is he even doing here? I thought he lived on Sodor. Well, apparently, Fat Hat doesn't give him any jobs anymore. So he decided to come back here and be loyal to me or something. And those two yellow guys down there, they also got kicked off because they tried to scrap this Oliver guy. I don't know what an Oliver is, but I'm only concerned about one. Seven. Seven people.
Quick question. Which 7 engines are you talking about?
Oh, you know. Toby, Percy, James, Gordon, Henry, Edward, and most importantly, that little blue puffball, Thomas.
Well, then what's your plan?
Simple. We're going to kidnap them. We'll strike at midnight. And by we, I mean two of you. And let's pick right now. I'm going to pick, Splatter and Dodge, yes.
But sir, how do you expect us to kidnap 7 engines in one night?
Oh, come on, I'm not that sadistic. I'm going to have you kidnap one of them. Not only will it save us energy, but it will also cause all 6 of the other ones to just crawl right to us.
Sir, why would kidnapping one of those 7 engines result in the other 6 crawling right to us? I thought they spent every single day saying how much they hate one another.
Well, yes, but at the end of the day, they have each other's backs.
You know, like Wario and Waluigi, Shrek and Donkey, Bart and Lisa. Come on, this is simple math, you guys.
Oh, I see. We need to be more like Waluigi.
No! That's not what I meant at all!
Aw, I got this new coat of purple paint for nothing.
Now, as for what we'll do once we have all 7 engines in our midst, I won't spoil it right now, but trust me, you'll love it.
Alright guys, are you ready to see the most dangerous stunt that's ever been pulled off in the history of stunts? Yeah, I'm ready to see a stunt.
Sorry, could you explain the stunt to me one more time?
I'm gonna jump across this unfinished bridge and land safely on the other side.
Guys, why are you just sitting around like this? Don't you all have work to do?
We can't work now, Edward. Thomas is going to do the big stunt.
Don't tell me this is another one of Thomas's harebrained schemes to get out of working.
Okay, I won't tell you.
It's not what I meant, Henry.
All right, enough chat. Let's get this show on the road.
Good luck, Thomas. You'll need it.
One for the money. Two for the show. Three to make ready. And four to go!
I knew we wouldn't be able to make it.
Guess I'll be getting rid of my rabbit foot.
It's a miracle you're okay, Thomas. Because as soon as we get you off this flatbed, you can get back to work.
Yay. Well, I'll just leave you to it. I imagine that's not how your plan was supposed to go, Thomas.
You know me so well, Duck. Now, how do you suppose we'll get me off of this flatbed without any sort of crane or anything?
Well, I guess we could try the old tablecloth trick.
Worth a shot.
One, two, three!
Well, that could have gone better.
What took you so long, Thomas?
Oh, well, no. Maybe it's got something to do with the fact that I had to do a day worth of jobs in only 3 hours.
Well, Thomas, what matters is that you made it back here in one piece.
I guess you have a point.
Good night. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Well, this is the place.
Well, why wouldn't it be the place? What other place would come with a motto so stupid?
Any American city, maybe? I guess you're right.
Well, I guess we better get this over with. How did you open the door without hands?
I don't know.
Perfect. It's Thomas. Did you remember to bring the note?
Yeah, I remembered it.
All right, let's get out of here.
Good morning, world, and all who inhabit it.
Could you keep it down, Henry? Some of us still require rest.
I'm with James on this one. I was having a dream about ruling the world.
You were having a dream about what?
Never mind.
Rise and shine, everyone. It's time to get to work.
I'm ready to get to work.
Guess Thomas must have gotten an early start.
Well, I'm gonna head out.
Hey, wait. What's this? This wasn't here last night. It's some kind of note.
Dear Sodor Engines, we've kidnapped that little blue puffball Thomas, and we're holding him hostage at our lair in Britain. I dare you to come and save him if you can. Love, Diesel 10? P.S. I don't know why I wrote love. I hate all of you. Oh, guys, this is terrible. Thomas is in trouble. We have to go save him.
Huh. You know, something about this turn of events seems kind of familiar, no?
I hate to kill the mood, Gordon, but there's still work to be done on this island. And with 7 engines out of commission, who's going to do all the work?
Come on, Edward. It's not like we're the only 7 engines on this island. You know, there's a Duck, Oliver, Bill and Ben, Donovan Douglas. I think there might have been a Barry, too, but there's lots of engines on this island.
Well, regardless of the work situation, we've got a friend to save. You know the drill, everyone. We meet up at the edge of Sodor and go over to Britain from there. Now let's move!
Henry, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I sure am.
Oh, brother.
Now that we're men, we can do anything, now that we're men. We are invincible, now that we're men. We'll go to Shell City, get the crown, save the crown, and Mr. Krabs. Now that we're men, we have facial hair, now that we're men.
I change my underwear,
now that we're men. We've got a manly flair, we've got the stuff, we're tough enough to save the day. We never had a chance when we were kids. No, no, no. But take a look at what the mermaid did. Ha, ha, ha. Hooray. Now that they're men, we can't bother them. Now that they're men, they have become our friends. Now that they're men, they'll be a happy end. They'll pass the test and finish the quest for the crown. They'll pass the test and finish the quest. They'll pass the test and finish the quest for the crown.
Great. Hooray! Britain, dead ahead. Yay! We made it, Henry. Yay! We got past everything.
Right.
Even the hideous, disgusting side characters.
Huh?
Aww. Not you guys. You guys are awesome.
Yeah.
Well, Henry, we should be there in one more verse.
Now that we're mad.
There you guys are. We've been waiting here for hours.
How do you know it was just a few hours? For all you know, it could have been a few days, or maybe even a month.
Well, let's not waste any more time talking about it, and let's go save Thomas.
All right, let's go.
Wakey, wakey, Thomas.
Ugh.
Thomas, wake up.
Ugh. Ugh. Where am I?
Rude. I would have thought you'd be thinking of this place as a second home by now.
Oh, great. It's you guys again. What do you want?
You know, Thomas, if you don't want to be here, you can't just leave.
Ugh, glad you still understand me, Harry.
What? A boot!
Can't believe you fell for that one.
All right, you guys, this isn't funny anymore. What's going on?
Old McDiesel had a plan.
Wait.
With a pinch that here like... and a pinch there. Here, pinch there, pinch.
Diesel
I cracked myself
10.
Up.
And
hello, Puffball. We reunite at last.
What do you want from me, Diesel 10?
It's not necessarily what I want from you. It's more what I want from all 7 of you. You know, you, Edward, Henry, Gordon, James, Percy, and Toby.
What do you mean by that?
When I had Splatter and Dodge kidnap you, I also had them leave a little note behind stating where you are.
Oh, so that means they'll just come here and save me. Not quite. But what do you mean, not quite? What I mean is, I'll be sending all of my minions out there to apprehend them and bring them back here so I can hold them hostage along with you.
That's just crazy.
It may be crazy, but it's also going to work.
In the meantime, Thomas, I'll put on some music for us. Isn't that great, Thomas? You can only get things like this on a computer.
There goes that gig.
All right, Diesels. I want you to go out there and find those other six engines and bring them back here alive.
All right, sir.
Spread the word to the rest of the Diesels. We need as many men as we can get for this operation. I'll stay here with Thomas.
Oh boy, this is gonna be a long day.
What's the plan, Gordon?
I'm thinking that our best course of action would be to invade Diesel 10's hideout from six sides, so that we can have the best chance of, you know, potentially sneaking in there undetected and getting Thomas out of there as soon as possible.
Well, I guess it's a good thing I packed my map of Britain.
Oh, really, Henry? Let's see it. Wow, Henry. Very professional.
Thanks.
Alrighty then. James, you're gonna go through the forest. Henry, you're gonna go through the countryside. Edward, you're gonna go through the beach. Toby and I are gonna go through London. And Percy, you're gonna have to go through the graveyard. Any questions?
Can I be the one who goes through the forest?
Okay, I guess it doesn't really matter who goes through where, All right, let's move out, everyone.
So this is the beach. Hey, look, there's some bathers out there.
Ooh, none of them are wearing any clothes.
Hey, look, now they're out playing in the water.
Speaking of water, I could probably use some.
Ooh, hey, a water fountain.
Huh. That's kind of weird. They would have a water truck right next to this water fountain. Wait.
Oh, I think there's something wrong with this water. Oh, I feel terrible.
Wait a minute. What? Harry and Bert, what are you doing?
That's an easy one, Edward. We're doing our job.
Wait a minute. You're with Diesel 10, aren't you?
Dead on, Edward. Boy, are you quick.
You're never going to get away with this. Never!
Would you smell that fresh country air?
Hello, what have we here?
Ooh, I am one good-looking class 28.
If there's a better-looking engine in the world, you need to tell me right now, because I need to go and kill him.
I'm definitely the best-looking engine in the world.
No doubt about that.
And if anybody tells me otherwise,
Oh, no!
The forest. Fresh air. Green trees. Click-clock wood playing in the background. Oh, it's perfect. Wait a minute. What's that? No, 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 no! A tree!
Oh, how could this happen?
Hey, stop the music!
Well, sorry. And besides, it's not like we have anything else to do.
Oh, this tree was over 300 years old, and in good health, too. Wait a minute. There's some sort of word carved into the trunk. Is it D? I better get out my handy-dandy guide to spelling difficult words. Let's see here, D, D-I-S, dis, T-R, distraction, that's it! But why would somebody carve distraction into a tree?
Ow!
Wait, Spam Can, is that you?
In the flesh. Now let's get a move on, old square wheels.
Well, what if I don't want to go with you?
Well, that's too bad.
Aww.
Well, this place sure has changed since the 20s.
Now where is that diesel there?
Did you lose your way again, Gordon?
No. Hello, Cousin Spencer.
Hello yourself, Gordon. Now what are you doing here? The railway show was 4 years ago.
This has nothing to do with you, Spencer. I'm here on business.
Well, what kind of business is that?
Well, it's a little bit complicated, but I guess you have the right to know.
Later.
And that's why I'm here.
Wow, Gordon. I guess we should leave you to it.
Yes, I should probably be going.
Ow! What? Bowler?
Yes, it's me. Now come on, we best not keep the boss waiting.
We should probably go help him out, shouldn't we?
Yeah, we probably should, but we have trains to pull first.
Oh no, they've got Gordon. Oh, maybe it was a mistake coming out here. Maybe I should just go back home and hide.
Don't talk like that, Toby. We just need to find a way to get into the diesel's lair without being noticed. You know?
Wait a minute. That's it. To get into the diesel lair, I need to disguise myself as a diesel.
And we're going to help you.
What follows is a brief construction montage. We hope you enjoyed this brief construction montage.
Well, it's done. What do you think, Toby?
I think I can't breathe.
Well, see you later.
Hey, I'm supposed to be looking for a brown tram engine called Toby. Have you seen him?
No, I haven't.
I'm kind of new around here. Do you know where you could help me find some jobs to do?
Okay. I mean, I'm sure Diesel 10 could use an extra hand.
That's a great idea. Let's go.
I have to be the one to come through here. Oh, come on, Percy, man up. It's just a boneyard. Full of bones. And broken engine parts. And whatever that is.
That sure is a big, scary-looking tree.
Hey, Percy. You remember me from that one time in the music video?
There's no such thing as zombies, or witches, or werewolves. It's all in your imagination. There's nothing to be afraid of here. Ah! Okay, that's just wrong. Who would make a statue of an ocean dragon?
That sure is a big spider.
Calm down, Percy. You're overreacting.
You can get through this.
Psst.
Huh?
Females.
Ah! All right, that's it. I'm not opening my eyes no matter what.
Nice job, Percy. You made my job a whole lot easier.
Diesel 10, I've got the last one here.
Excellent. The plan was a complete success.
Ugh. You know, I was half expecting at least a few of you to fail, but... all of you? Ugh, I don't believe it.
Yeah, me neither, Thomas.
Well, you're not all here. I wasn't able to find Toby.
Are you an idiot? He's literally right there.
I'm not Toby. I'm, Tobias.
Hey, wait, what are you doing?
Surprise. Well, you certainly had me fooled, Toby.
All right, boss, what do we do with these engines now?
Simple.
You're going to shut them down tracks 6, 7, and 8.
What? But sir, you swore we would never use those tracks again.
Well, sometimes swears like that are meant to be broken. Now let's get a move on, everyone.
Oh, no. What do you think's gonna happen to us, Gordon? I don't know, Thomas, but hopefully not. Meaning, I guess we'll find out. Well, it's suddenly gotten really warm in here. What are they gonna do to us? Oh, no. Oh, where are we?
You're gonna go to a fun place.
A fun place? What do you mean?
You know, a place with warm weather and sunshine and all the tangerines you want.
I'm sold. Let's go.
Okay, cut the crap, Diesel 10. Where are we?
This is your final resting place. What do you mean by that?
What do I mean by that? What do I mean by that? Look around you.
Oh no, this is a smelting room.
That's exactly correct. Now, Diesels, push all 7 of them in.
Not this time, Diesel 10. I won't take your orders any longer. Yeah, me neither.
All right, have it your way. Diesels, push Splatter and Dodge in too.
Diesel 10, how did it get like this?
Do you understand, Puffball? That I've spent 7 years in solitude. I have had nothing to do but have grudges against you and all of these other tin kettles. And now is my day. Now is my day that I will get my revenge once and for all.
All right, guys, let's get this over with.
I guess this is it, friends. This is our final goodbye. There's so many things I haven't gotten to do yet, like riding an Uber. I never told my brother I love him. I never got to finish that novel. I didn't get to sleep in this morning. Goodbye, everyone. I guess I'll see you in a few minutes.
Yes. Yes. Yes!
Hey! Stop what you're doing!
Hi, I'm Percy with today's viewer mail. Here's a letter from Violet, age 5. Dear Percy, are you sure there's enough time in the show to do this? Good question, Violet. The answer is no. Bye-bye.
It's Spencer!
Diesels, get rid of them!
All right,
guys, I think now might be a good time to run for it!
Come on, everyone! This way! Alright, everyone, let's get out of here before... Ow!
You're not getting away that easily!
Guys, go on without me! We'll never forget you, Thomas!
Looks like I'm gonna have to settle for just you, then, Puffball! I may go down, Diesel 10, but I'm gonna go down with a fight!
Ow! Ah, my eyes!
Whoa! Huh, thanks, Buffers, you saved me. Thanks a lot.
That's it! I'm done messing around! See you in hell, Puffball!
What the...
No! He's dead.
Mm-hmm. I did what I had to do to save my friend.
I'm your friend?
Yes. I never thought I would actually admit it to your face, but I do think of you as a friend. But, alright, let's get out of here.
Thanks for helping us out back there, Spencer.
I hate you a little less now.
It was the least we could do.
Love to stay and chat, but we gotta take these diesels away now.
Well, goodbye. Maybe someday we'll learn your name, too.
Alright, let's go, Spencer.
We're really sorry we helped Diesel 10 try to annihilate you guys.
Well, maybe someday we'll be able to forgive you. And maybe someday we could invite you to live on Sodor with us.
Oh, really? That'd be awesome. Thanks.
Well, for right now, I think it's best the seven of us get home now.
Oh, thank God. I hated this place.
All right, everybody. Let's go home.
You know, this reminds me of a song.
Ooh, I see what you're getting at.
Lord help me if they start singing again.
He's a really useful engine, you know.
All the other engines, they'll tell you so.
He huffs and puffs and whistles, rushing to and fro. He's a really useful engine, we all know. He's the one. He's a really useful engine that we all know. He's the number one, Thomas the Tank Engine.
Home sweet home at last.
What are we waiting for? Christmas? Let's go.
He's a really useful engine, you know.
'Cause Mr. Fat, he told him so.
Now he's got a branch line to call his very own. He's a really useful engine, we all know. He's the one. He's a really useful engine that we all know. He's the number one, Thomas the Tank Engine. Little Blue Train, he's always there whenever we need a hand.
If we need help with a situation, he comes into mind.
He's the one. He's a really useful engine that we all know. He's the number one, Thomas the Tank Engine.
Come on, guys, sing along.
He's a really useful engine, you know. Maybe little, but he's never slow.
stand back in amazement and see what he can do. He's a really useful engine, we all know. He's the one. He's the one. He's a really useful engine that we all know. He's the one. He's the number one. Thomas the Tank Engine. He's a really useful engine, we all know.
Ah, it's so nice to be back home again.
Yeah, especially since we don't even need to worry about Diesel 10 anymore.
Do you guys think this is supposed to be funny? You're sitting around talking about Diesel 10 when there's 2 days of work to be done? See, I told you there was work to be done. This is not the time, Edward.
Sorry. You better get started. You got a lot of catchy upying to do.
Well, I guess I should go and pull my express train, right after I take a little snooze.
Yeah, Gordon's been right. We have been awake for a long time.
See you whenever. Nap time. Oh, I am so tired.
Oh, I could use some beauty sleep. Good night, world, and all who inhabit it.
Well, friends, that's the end of the story of where Diesel 10 has been all these years. Now, I'm sure you're still wondering, all these 7 engines we've been focusing on this whole time, where are they now?
Distance may sadden.